What's up everyone, Mandy here from On The Grow, and today we're doing another microgreens nutrient experiment, but this time we're gonna be adding worm poop directly to our coco coir to see how it affects the growth. So stay tuned for the video. Worm castings are an organic form of fertilizer produced from earthworms through earthworm waste or worm poo as they eat compost. Worm castings improve soil aeration and drainage, as well as increase water retention in the soil, along with containing tons of nutrients. They can also be applied to any plant without burning them, which is always a plus. I know that sounds kind of gross, but it's actually a really great nutrient that you can add to basically any soil or soil-like medium. Now, if you aren't familiar with our channel, something that we love to do is we love to teach people how to grow things like these microgreens and other plants as well. And we love to do experiments. We do all kinds of experiments with different nutrients, different grow lights, and basically anything that we can get our hands on that can benefit a plant's overall taste, appearance, and growth. What we're going to be doing today is we actually have an experiment using those worm castings that we want to talk about. So I'm going to go ahead and move this off of this shelf here and onto my table. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and talk about this experiment here in front of me. So first off, this is an experiment using worm castings mixed into our coconut coir. And we're using this company right here, which was so nice to send us this bag for free for us to test out. Now, before we actually started doing this test for our YouTube video, we tested this product off camera and we got such amazing results that we thought it'd be fun to actually show you guys what this product can do. So let's go ahead and talk about what's going on here with these trays. So each one of these trays has 3 cups of coconut coir per tray, and they were all seeded with 11.5 grams of pak choi cabbage per tray. They all went through the same germination period, which was 4 days, which breaks down to 3 days underweight and 1 day in blackout. Now, on top of that, these were all underneath our Barina T5 lights for 5 days, and we are currently on day 10 of this grow. Now, the only thing that was different here is our 2 yellow label trays had only coconut coir in the tray as a grow medium. And our 2 red label trays, they had coconut coir plus 1 cup of this worm casting mixed in to their trays. Now, these were all bottom watered with just plain water, so that way we can kind of see what the benefits of this product is against coconut coir without any nutrients. So now let's go ahead and take a closer look at each of these and see what's going on here in front of me. Now, these two were just on coconut coir by itself, bottom watered with plain water, and this is what the growth looks like. It is rather even across the top of this with one little low spot here. And I will say that the cotyledon sizes are a little bit sporadic. Some of them are very tiny, and then some of the ones that are on the edge are a little bit bigger than the ones in the middle. Now, taking a look at the second one, I'd say these are pretty much even for the most part, though this one seems to be just a tad bit more developed than our first one. But I will say that both of these trays, the growth on them is actually really nice, and I'm very happy with what we got here. But if we go look at our 2 worm casting trays, clearly there is a difference with both of them compared to our first 2 trays. Now, both of these are a little bit taller in their growth, and also they have widened out quite a bit on our sides, and our cotyledon size on these is really nice. I'm loving the size of these. They're not too big, not too small, and we're just now starting to get that true leaf coming through, which that's exactly what we want to see today because the height on these is perfect right now. So with that being said, today is actually going to be harvest day for all 4 of these trays because we don't want that true leaf to develop anymore or it's going to become bitter. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to get this table a little bit more cleaned off, prepare it for harvest, and then we will go over the harvest weight, taste, and appearance of each of these and see if there is actually any more benefits other than just the growth. So I'll see you guys here in a second. I just got done harvesting all 4 of our trays, but before we get into those harvest weights, if you wouldn't mind smashing that thumbs up button and also hit that subscribe button and our notification bell so that way you get notified anytime we release new videos just like this one. So let's go ahead and get into it. Starting with our 2 over here, these are going to be our plain coco coir trays. And then the 2 on my right are actually the ones that had the worm castings added to it. So let's go ahead and start on these ones. For 1 of these trays, I got a harvest weight of 171 grams. The other tray got a harvest weight of 157 grams. That means that there was a 14 gram difference between our two Coco Coir trays, and the average of these trays was 164 grams. Now for my two trays that had the added worm castings. I got 228 grams for one tray and 227 grams for the other. That means there was only a 1 gram difference between these trays, and the average for these was 227.5 grams. The difference between these two groups, which is the Coco Coir versus the worm castings of Coco Coir, is 63.5 grams in favor of our worm castings. So for that part of the test, clearly our worm castings have won. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the appearance. Starting with my two just plain Coco Coir trays. I love this height, it's not too big. And also something about this crop is it has this beautiful white stem, and I really like how clear it is on this. And then the greens in this is actually pretty nice. I feel like they are a little bit pale, but I think that that might just be this particular crop. It's hard to say here, but overall I think the appearance on these is really beautiful. Now with our two over on the worm casting side, once again the height on these is pretty good. I think it's about the same as some of these. I'm going to pull some up so we can look. They're, yeah, pretty similar in height for the most part. I'm sure there's some here that are actually taller. And then the coloration on them is pretty similar. I was hoping to see a little bit more darker greens in this, but it looks pretty close to our two Coco Coir trays. The one thing I am seeing that is a big difference is some of them are taller and the cotyledon size are much larger than they are on our two that had no worm castings, which that makes complete sense because anytime that we add nutrients into the mix, we tend to get larger cotyledons and more explosive growth. So that's a good thing to see. So that means these are working. For the winner of appearance, I'm actually gonna go with my worm castings. I just love that the cotyledon size is a little bit bigger than they are over on my Coco Coir trays. Plus, I feel like they're a lot more even in their growth than I'm seeing on my plain Coco Coir trays. Let's go ahead and do a blind taste test of these. So I'm gonna put this blindfold on and CJ's gonna hand me some of these at random and we're gonna taste out this flavor. Bloop! I feel like this is what blind dates are like. Do you wear blindfolds? Mmm, that had a burst of flavor almost immediately. Kind of faded a little quick though, but it did have a lot of flavor and a nice crunch to that. I like that group. That one, instead of being an initial burst of like brassica flavor, it was pretty bitter. That was the same group as the last one. Now the bitter, it's just like, it's green. It tastes green. That was the same as the first group. That had a ton of flavor, brassica flavor, no bitterness, no green flavor. That one tasted really nice. I'm gonna guess either those were the same groups or maybe it had to do with the placement on the shelf. The first group, the moment that I bit into it, I got this beautiful brassica flavor that I really loved. But then when I went into my second group, it was really bitter and green tasting instead of having that nice brassica flavor, which I really didn't like. It was not good. And then the group after that, it was once again just like that second group where it was just bitter and green. And I actually guessed that that was part of the same group because they both had that same flavor. And then our very last group was just like our first one. Tons of flavor. It was really nice. No bitterness and no green. So clearly it's group number one and four, almost reality math, one and four that I really enjoyed. And if I had to guess, my body is saying that that was Coco Coir. Did I get that right?
You did.
I did. Ooh, I don't know why, but something just told me that it was these guys. I don't know if that's because of tests that we've done in the past with water where we actually have gotten a nice flavor from it. And I felt that maybe the other groups were too developed. And when a crop gets too developed, that's whenever you start to taste things that are bitter and green tasting, which is what I tasted. So clearly the winner of flavor is our Coco Coir trays that had no worm castings in it. Let's go ahead and quickly recap. So the winner for our weight was the worm castings. Our winner for the appearance was also the worm castings, but the winner for the taste was our plain cocoa trays. Personally, I'm gonna go with our Coco Coir tray because this just gave me such great flavor. And if it doesn't have good flavor, you're not gonna wanna eat it at home. And also, if you're selling this product, if it doesn't taste good, people aren't gonna wanna come back. Now I wanna go ahead and talk about our cost here. For our trays, for just a single tray with just plain cocoa, it is 28 cents for the 3 cups of cocoa. But for our worm casting trays, it's 28 cents for the plain cocoa, plus you're adding in 70 extra cents for the worm castings. So that means that our worm casting trays are 98 cents per tray. The cost of our two worm casting trays was substantially higher, though it did give us a higher yield. It also resulted in a bitter flavor. And this could have been caused either from them getting nutrients too soon or too quick, or also from the faster growth. But with that being said, we're gonna have to play around with this a little bit more and see if we can figure out what is causing that bitterness. But nonetheless, I am extremely happy with how our two Coco Coir trays turned out. We got great flavor on these, and overall this product was just perfect. I'm extremely happy with how this experiment turned out, and I was actually kind of shocked that the flavor on our water was much better than that of our worm castings. But like I said before, this is something that we're gonna continue to play around with. We plan on doing some more worm casting tests where we actually add this into other soils, maybe do some more Coco Coir tests. I don't know, but either way, we're gonna keep on using this product and see what it can do for us, because we do hear a lot how good worm castings are. So if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you dislike it, give us a thumbs down. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the section below. We have a Facebook and an Instagram that are both at On The Grow Farms, and we have a lovely website, which is www.onthegrow.net. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and keep on believing.